Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly love reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Now, I did want to go deeper into your love reading. So I'm going to be pulling out some shells. And from there, we're going to jump into your reading, Aquarius. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the month of December 2019 in regards to your love and romance. Spirit, guys, what are the messages for Aquarius in regards to the love and romance? Okay, let's see. All right, Aquarius. All right, so in your past and passing, I do see you guys being a little bit more focused. A lot of you guys have been experiencing a lot of stress, and this could be directly connected in regards to your finances or in regards to your business. Now, for others of you, this could represent having or putting more effort into making more money than perhaps putting the time and effort into relationships and partnerships. I think that that's something that has taken up a lot of your time, Aquarius, for the year of 2019. And I think that that's quickly going to start changing for you guys. Although sometimes you guys may not be that excited when it comes to changes, I do see changes coming for you and towards you in regards to your love and romance. Now, I do want to let you guys know that there may be an opportunity of partnership or relationship. As I do see in regards to your love, I do see an opportunity coming for you, and this is a new beginning. I think that for those of you guys that have been single for quite a while, complacency is something that is not good, Aquarius, because this represents standing still. This represents not wanting or not seeing movement or progress in regards to your relationships or in regards to partnerships. And it's going to be something that is going to quickly start to change for you guys, especially for 2020. But what they're saying is complacency is something that you need to let go of. That's an old behavior, an old pattern that you need to shed or that you need to, like I said, let go of at this present time. Because that's what's basically what they're saying is what's keeping you from finding the partnership or from finding a relationship has a lot to do with the decision, the rational decision that you've made of being comfortable. And though for some of you guys, you've kind of tried to convince yourself that you're happy or that you are in a good place in your life, what Spirit is telling you is that there's still a feeling of loneliness or a feeling of, like I said, frustration because there's no progress, but you're not going to be able to see progress if you're not willing to make that change or that move, Aquarius. Now, in your very near future unfolding, I do see you being almost a feeling of being at crossroads and having to make a decision. For some of you guys, it could be a decision in regards to your finances. It could be a new opportunity in regards to the way you make money. It could be getting an opportunity to either change companies or, again, having to, you know, choose to stay where you're at because you're comfortable. But what Spirit is telling you is that if you're wanting changes and you want to see progress in your life, it comes at the expense of your comfortability. So you got to take that with you. Take it with a grain of salt, but understand that, Aquarius. Okay. Now let's get right into your readings in regards to your love life. All right. So your first card here is the Nine of Swords, and this is a current position. So for some of you guys, you may be experiencing having a lot of restlessness, a lot of trouble sleeping, not being able to sleep, or for some of you guys, even experiencing insomniac type of energy, usually signifies like being up late at night. Now, the obstacle here is the Nine of Wands. So again, when it comes to your relationships, for some of you guys, it could represent having almost like difficulty in the present time. For some of you guys, those of you guys that are in a long-term committed relationship, there's a lot of stress and a lot of worry that is connected to, again, could have something to do with how you make your money that is affecting you. But for others, it could just be experiencing like a lot of tiredness or restlessness that the relationship is bringing to you or that is bringing to your life, where perhaps there is a feeling of giving up or wanting to walk away, because the Nine of Wands does signify the obstacle. So someone in the relationship is, for those of you guys that are in a relationship, someone in the relationship is left feeling like they've put too much effort or like they've put too much time and energy and they're no longer wanting to do that. Now, this is a general reading. You guys have to remember that I'm reading for thousands of you out there. So it could be vice versa because it is a general reading. Now, in the past and passing, you have here the Five of Cups. So the Five of Cups, so I'm getting different messages. For some of you guys, perhaps you're mourning the loss of a relationship. Perhaps there was someone that gave up on the relationship and there's been either an ending to it. For others of you, it could be that you're still dealing with the loss of a relationship that perhaps happened a couple of months ago, but the hurt is still there present. And there is almost a feeling or a desire of wanting to connect, wanting to communicate with that person. But again, a lot of tired energy. So I feel that for a lot of you guys, you may be experiencing this for quite a while now. And for others of you, it could just symbolize that you are still going through that loss and that hurt, even though it's happened. For some of you guys, it could have even been years ago as well, and still wanting to have that connection or that communication that perhaps never came through for you. Now, what's crowning you in the present is the Six of Wands. So the Six of Wands is moving forward, being able to move forward, being able to move past the feeling of hurt or the feeling of mourning. For some of you guys, it could also represent, for those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, it could signify the mourning of a loss of a family member, someone that passed on to the astral world. And it's almost like around this time, you're very much in your head, Aquarius, or again, like I said, you're still going through that mourning, that loss. And it's quite difficult for some of you guys. It could have even been like a mother figure or a father figure, as I do see the Empress card here. But with the Six of Swords, I do see progress and being able to find emotional balance or emotional fulfillment. Now, you do have here the Ace of Cups. So I'm getting two different messages. For some of you guys, it could be mourning or still mourning the loss of a relative or someone that passed on, and not really opening up to your partner. And I think around these days or around this time of holidays, it's really bringing out that the missing of that person on the physical level. But with the Ace of Cups here, I do see that there's going to be a lot of love or a lot of support around you. This could be with relatives, this could be family members, or this can even be your partner that is trying to be emotionally understanding and wanting to give you that emotional support. Now, the advice card here for you, Aquarians, is the Ten of Cups. Now, for those of you guys that have been single for quite a while and you went through a situation where perhaps you felt like you've gave it the best you had and it just didn't work out, I see that for some of you guys, perhaps you were complacent because you've kind of given up. But what Spirit is telling you is that there is opportunities in regards to romance that are going to be coming out or coming towards you for the month of not just December, but for 2020. As I do see the opportunity to have emotional fulfillment as well as happiness and or marriage for some of you. Now, the energy of those around you is the Six of Wands. So the Six of Wands speaks to me about being very receptive type of energy, people around you understanding or knowing. There's almost a congratulatory type of energy. For some of you guys, it could be visiting your motherland. For others of you, it could be returning to what you would consider home. Again, it could have to do with the holidays and just revisiting, you know, the past or whatnot. But I do see here the Two of Cups. So the Two of Cups, okay, Now, this is going to be a very direct message. I was going to say, let me pull one more card out. So you have the Knight of Wands, and the Knight of Wands is very quick movement. Now, the Knight of Wands is very connected to the Empress card. So I feel that for some of you guys, perhaps you became complacent because there was children involved, and you've kind of convinced yourself that you wanted to be there for your child and that you wanted to provide that parental support. But what Spirit is telling you is that you're going into a new phase in your life. This is a new cycle that is beginning. And you need to remember that you need to put effort and time in regards to partnerships. Now, this is not to say for those of you guys out there that are single or have been single for a while that you're not happy. Not at all. But what they're saying is that if you've convinced yourself that you are comfortable and that you are happy in this present time, is it because you're trying to convince yourself or is it because you genuinely feel that way? And if it is, are you doing things that you're very passionate about? And if the answer to that is no, then perhaps you're lacking that. And what they're saying is that you need to remember that it's not just in regards to relationships, it's not just partnerships, it's not just business. We have every single different aspect in our life that we need to maintain, that we need to feed, to be able to grow into the best version of ourselves. Now, for those of you guys that are not happily single, again, like what they're telling me is that you need to remember that you need to get out of your comfort zone, Aquarius. That's the only way you're going to be able to fortify or have this connection, because I do see longevity in this partnership that's coming through for you. And I feel that this is very fresh, fresh energy. So this is nothing to do with people that you've dealt with in the past. This is nothing to do with people that perhaps are around you. This is a new energy. This is a new person coming towards you. For some of you guys, this could be a fire energy, Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries. For others of you, it could be Pisces energy or water energy, Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer, or Libra. For some of you guys as well, as I do have the Empress card here. But again, what they're saying is that in order for you to be able to experience what a partnership is, and not that of what we've experienced in the past, but balanced relationships, you have to get yourself out of your comfort zone, or you got to get out of your head, is what they're saying. There's been a lot of like negative experiences in the past that really marked you or really had a major effect on the way you see love in this present time. And what they're saying is that the experiences that we go through are meant to teach us something, and they're meant for us to build character, to become stronger, spiritual, more conscious energy. Once you've done that, you have to move on to the next cycle of your life. You can't be stuck. So again, I hope you guys take that with a grain of salt. Now let's get into your specific message from Spirit. And your card is, your dreams need a practical plan. Full moon in Taurus. So again, we go back to what the message was. You need to get out of your comfort zone, Aquarius. You need to expose yourself or put yourself, perhaps do things that you've never done in the past, not because of anything other than for experience. But for those of you guys that are genuinely looking for a relationship, you're not going to find that person come into your home and knock on your door and say, I'm here for you, Aquarius. You have to put effort in that as well. So again, when it comes to manifesting, or when it comes to, again, like the shells were saying, putting a lot of effort and energy towards business, that's great and all. But do you have a set goal? Do you have the aspirations that you're trying to achieve? Do you know how to go from just, you know, thinking about it or wanting it to actually taking charge or making a move to make that happen? And if the answer is no, then it's consider yourself like a boat in the sea without any sail. you have no destination. So you got to be more practical in the approach to what you're wanting to bring into your life, whether it's relationships, whether it's reconnecting with perhaps family members that you're no longer connected to, or perhaps there was a falling out. All of this has a lot to do, and it greatly impacts us in every single aspect of our lives. So again, what they're telling you here is you need to take a practical approach. Be more mindful. And again, like I said, almost like use a roadmap towards what you're wanting to achieve. And within that, making, you know, decisions or movements or plans about how to make that happen. Okay. So I hope you guys enjoyed these readings. Like, share, and comment. And we will see each other for January 2020.